Deborah Borchardt, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. Just a heads up, everyone, our next conference is in Los Angeles, September 11th and 12th. It's called The Economics of Branding, and it will do a deep dive into all the facets of branding in the cannabis industry. Go to www.greenmarketsummit.com for more details and to buy tickets. The bad news just keeps coming for CanTrust. This week, the company said that Ontario informed them that some of its products are non-conforming under the Master Cannabis Supply Agreement. It has opted to return the product valued at $2.9 million Canadian dollars. CanTrust did note that Health Canada has not ordered a recall of its products. Iantha secured a $50 million loan for expansion purposes. BDS Analytics closed on a $7 million round of financing, as did Helix Biopharma. There were still some earnings coming out this week. Cresco Labs reported that its revenue rose 253% to $29.9 million year over year and 42% sequentially. They still reported a net loss of $3.9 million, although some of the blame for that went to tax items related to acquisitions. TerrAscend reported second quarter revenue of $17.6 million, and they raised their guidance for the full year to $141 million from $135 million. Now, having said that, the net loss jumped to $21 million from last year's net loss of $5 million. Indus Holdings reported second quarter revenue rose 183% to $9.7 million over last year, and that was a 51% jump over the first quarter. Manifest 7 acquired the Haven Dispensary in Santa Ana, while Acquired Sales bought CBD Lion. We have some stock moves to go over this week. Organigram got approval from the Toronto Stock Exchange to begin trading, and they will keep the symbol OGI. Cansortia began trading on the OTCQB with the symbol CNTMF, along with Empower Clinics using the symbol EPWCF. Valens Growworks began trading on the OTCQX exchange this week with the ticker VGWCF. And that's it. Hey, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. It won't cost you anything. It's free. I'm Deborah Borchardt reporting for the Green Market Report from Times Square.